This is Dr. Keith Miller from Kansas State University. And what I'm going to do with this demonstration is illustrate a very important concept, very important factor that affects both global atmospheric circulation and weather patterns, and that's the Coriolis effect. Coriolis effect is a consequence of the differential rotation of the Earth's equator versus the poles. And because the Earth is spinning, and if you imagine someone standing at the equator, in a 24-hour period, they travel entirely around the circumference of the Earth, which means they're moving at a velocity of something like 1,000 miles per hour from someone standing outside of the Earth. While as a person who's at the poles is essentially stationary. And this differential motion of the Earth's surface relative to latitude, the position on the globe, generates the effect called the Coriolis effect. So to illustrate this, we're going to use a playground merry-go-round to act as an illustration of the Coriolis effect and the spinning Earth. Okay, we're taking this playground merry-go-round as a illustration of the rotating Earth. So instead of a sphere, we have a flat disk. But notice that the person in the middle, essentially at the poles, is moving very little. They're just rotating around in place. Whereas the person on the outside is moving at a much higher rate, a much higher velocity than the person in the center. And this is the whole basis of the Coriolis effect, where you have two people moving at different rates, and different velocities at different places on a sphere, or in this case, on a disk. So we can use this merry-go-round as an example of the spinning Earth. The Coriolis effect also works from any two positions on a rotating disk or a rotating globe, even across the axis of rotation. So as in this image with two people on opposite sides of the axis of rotation, the Coriolis effect is still operable because the two individuals are moving in different directions on the opposite sides of the disk. To begin with, we have the ball being thrown back and forth on a stationary disk. Now we're rotating the disk counterclockwise. This would be the same direction of rotation as in the Earth's northern hemisphere. Notice that the ball is always moving to the right of the intended recipient of the ball. This is a deflection, and a Coriolis effect is always to the right. If we now have the rotation going clockwise, that is the direction of the rotation of the southern hemisphere viewed at the South Pole, the deflection will be to the left in the opposite direction to that of the northern hemisphere.